In the beginning, there was a boy who got in some trouble. So much trouble, he wasn't allowed to leave his room. Because of this, he was bored one day and went online to watch some YouTube videos on how to hack PSPs.
After watching these videos, he realized people are very shitty at making hacking videos and thought he could do better himself. So what does he do? Well, he goes out with a little money he had and bought a camera to start recording videos.
Soon after starting to make these video tutorials for people, people actually started to comment and tell them that they were thankful and that they really helped him. Sadly, the people who were developing the PSP software stopped, but he still had a burning passion to creating videos, and he started to move on to creating Let's Plays.
From that point on, he knew he wanted to do this for the rest of his life. He started out with his favorite game, Final Fantasy VII, even though he knew, deep down, he wasn't very good at editing, and not very good at commentating. He kept going because he knew that with time and effort, he would get better and better.
After a while, he started to gain more confidence and started to talk with other YouTubers. He starts to build not only professional relationships with some people, but also a family relationship.
This makes him more and more eager to pursue his dream of making content for the world. Time goes by, videos are posted, he is asked on a frequent basis,
"Why not stream on Twitch TV? You would be good at it."
After months of consideration, he decides,
"Fuck it, why not?"
He later finds a passion for streaming and the interaction he can have with people live, right then and there.
This becomes somewhat of a second addiction for him, the first being YouTube. As time goes on, he progresses slowly but surely on both platforms, doing stupid stuff for people's enjoyment, i.e. challenges and waxing his legs on stream for everyone to see. Yeah, he is a bit careless and stupid, but he loves doing it to get the reaction of his viewers.
He has had many ups and downs, from his favorite YouTuber Boogie2988 liking his video as well as following him on Twitter, to the love of his life leaving him, but he never lets that get the best of him.
He continues to do what makes him happy, and whoever say he's wrong for this can fuck right off.
I can proudly say that on August 11th, 2014, that I love doing what I do, and I will never stop. So thank you guys so much for watching this 2-year anniversary video. I know it's a little bit late. It should have been posted up early this morning. As you can see, I just recorded my final part at the end right now. I'm wearing the same shirt I'm doing it. It took me a long time to get to where I am today. It's taken me 2 years to achieve the goals that I've achieved here on YouTube, as well as I explained through the story that you guys heard on Twitch as well. I'd just like to thank every single one of the people who came out and helped me with this little project, who did the voiceovers for me and all that kind of stuff. I'm sorry that all you guys get to see in the background is each person's like photo or avatar, whatever the hell you want to call it. I honestly couldn't, it spent so much fucking time thinking of what I was going to put in the background, and I honestly couldn't think of something that would actually fit all the way. I was going to do gameplay, but I just didn't feel that that would be right. So before I ramble on too much longer, thank you guys again so much for your guys' constant support, and I love every single one of you, and I will see you guys in the next video.